Dear students, welcome to our today's online session. How are you all? Hope you are studying your chapters on the day itself. So today we are going to discuss a new chapter from your textbook.
Now listen to the summary of the chapter. So our main character is Professor Gainton. When the chapter begins, he was traveling from Pune to Bombay via Jijamata Express, a train which was faster than the Deccan Queen. As he was crossing towns and villages, he met a man named Khan Sahib, who talked about his business and chatted about several things. They got off at Victoria Terminus Station, which was neat and clean. It had British offices, Parsis, Anglo-Indian staff all around. So seeing these British officers, these Anglo-Indian staffs and these Parsis there, Professor Gaintok was confused. He was confused as to how East India Company was ruling the country, because they had fled from our country after the events of 1857. But he could still see East India Company there, office there. He could see the British officers there. He could see the Parsis there. He could see the Anglo-Indians. So he was completely confused. Think, you are traveling to some other place. Suppose you are traveling to Mumbai. You are expecting to get down at Victoria Terminal, Mumbai Railway Station, and see the present age station. When you reached there, you are seeing a old railway station where you could find Britishers, British officials, Indian Rajas and Queens. How you will feel? You will be confused, right? So our Gaintown was also so confused. He went to the Hornby Road and noticed that the shops were different. Something is different. It's not like he used to see. He entered the Forbes building and inquired about Mr. Vinay Gaintown, but as checked by the receptionist, no such man had ever worked there. He went to the town hall and sat in the reading room. He took 5 books related to the history and decided to go through them one by one and check how the facts had changed. He started investigating from the period of Ashoka to the third battle of Panipat. So seeing all these things, he got confused. Definitely he will get confused, because he didn't expect to reach to a time of 1857, a time before 1857. So he wanted to find out what happened actually. For the purpose, he went to the library, took a book and started to read the history. Where and when it went wrong, he wanted to find out when and where events went wrong. So he started to read till the third battle of Panipat. I believe you know the third battle of Panipat and the incidents happened. So there is a short recall of this event in our chapter 2. If you don't remember, don't worry, we will discuss it in between. According to the 5th volume of Bhakkar, he found out that Marathas had won the battle of Panipat and spread their influence all over India after that. So in that book, he read like that: Marathas won the battle of Panipat and they spread their influence all over India after that. This is the information he could collect from the book. He was again confused, because the real history was something different, was different from what he knew. After the victory, India was moved to the path of democracy. There were no longer any kings ruling and democratic parties had been set up. The professor started liking India as he kept reading further about it. It was different from the one he believed he saw. This country knew how to stand on its feet and was no longer slave under the white man. So this is the history written over there. Entirely different from the real history. In real history, Marathas lost the battle. But in this book, it is written something different, like Marathas won and India was not enslaved by, or the Indians were not enslaved by the Britishers. As he was going through the book, the librarian told him to finish reading, since they were closing the library. It was 8 o'clock. He asked about carrying the books with him as he would return the next morning and slipped the Bakar book into his left pocket. He checked into a guest house and had his dinner. He decided to walk towards Azad Maidan. He noticed a large crowd of people going towards a pandal, a platform. A lecture was going on, but he noticed something unusual. The presidential chair was empty. The speaker was talking and the crowd was continuously moving inside and outside. So he decided to walk to Azad Maidan. There he found a platform, but what was different, what was unusual about that platform? There was no one to preside the function. Presidential chair was empty. Someone was talking, someone was giving a speech. People are moving inside and outside the ground. So this was unusual, right? Whenever there is a meeting, whenever there is a function, there will be someone to preside over the function, right? So in this lecture, in this platform, there was no one to preside the function. So he saw that. And then what happened? He could not control himself and moved towards the stage and sat on the chair. The crowd was taken aback, started asking him to get up and move away. He tried to talk to them, but they started throwing several objects at him, such as tomatoes, eggs, etc. Soon, the crowd moved towards him to push him away, and he was nowhere to be seen. That's it. So he went, sat in the chair. The crowds who were surrounding the platform didn't like it. They started to throw things at him like tomatoes and eggs, and they pushed him away. Now he is nowhere to be seen. Next, he woke up in a hospital and saw Rajendra in front of him. He narrated the whole sequence of events that took place, and Rajendra listened to him amazed. The professor was confused as to where he was and if he had been in a coma for the past 2 days. What was the experience he just had? Was it real or not? So the past 2 days, if he were in a coma, what the things that he experienced, like he went to the station, he got down there, he saw Britishers, Parsis and Anglo-Indians over there. He was able to read a book from the library, a history book from the library, in which the whole history was written ulta, and India was no more enslaved by Britishers. Again, when he reached to Azad Maidan, what he saw? A meeting without a person to preside over. When he sat there, how people reacted. So he wanted to know whether it was just his imagination or whether something real happened or not. So this is where we are stopping our class for today. I hope you will read the text today itself. Read the text, because it's about time traveling. So jumping from one event to the other event, when you are reading the text, you will come to know that one paragraph is about the past, one is about the present. So it goes like that, skipping from one to the other. So read the text today itself, otherwise it will be difficult for you to understand the context when you are keeping it for another day. So download the note and keep it for your future reference. Till we meet in our next session, take care, be safe, bye-bye.